the 1951 Vincent 998cc Black Lightning that Jack Ehret used to break the Australian speed record sold for almost $1 million in January, the most valuable motorcycle ever sold at auction. A 1951 Vincent 998cc Black Lightning changed hands for $929,000 at the Bonhams Las Vegas sale in January. Only 30 Black Lightning models were built at Vincent's Stevenage factory, making this one of the rarest bikes in the world, but this lot was particularly special. It broke the Australian speed record in the hands of Jack Ehret in 1953, after reaching 141.5 miles per hour on an empty stretch of road in New South Wales that year. Ehret continued to compete with the bike around Australia. Indeed, their final race together, Man and Machine, was in 1993. Since then, the bike has spent time in storage and in international ownership before being recommissioned and sold earlier this year. In a rare interview, we speak to its new owner Peter Bender, who, having bought the record-breaking bike in January, has returned it to the country where it made its name. Why motorbikes, Peter? I started riding bikes at a young age on our farm, and then took up trials on a 1976 Baltico Sherpa T. My first old British bike was a 1956 Matchless Gels, a one-owner bike that was originally owned by an old man who lived nearby. I bought it in the late 70s, and it was in pretty poor condition. That was my first go at restoring bikes, and I still have it today. It has since been re-restored, as my first efforts weren't quite as good as they are now. From then on, I really loved old British bikes in particular and accumulated a few fairly average ones over the next 20 or 30 years. Some I kept, but some I sold, such as old PSA C10S and C11S, which wouldn't pull the skin off a rice pudding. It wasn't until the last decade or so, when our business of salmon farming became profitable, that I could afford to buy more exotic machinery such as the Black Lightning. It's not the most beautiful thing on two wheels, nor is it the best kept, but this motorcycle remains one of the world's most famous. Credit William Mees. I had been aware of the bike for some time when it was under its second most recent ownership. I'd read about it in a couple of magazines, and a Black Lightning was always top of my list of bucket list bikes. For the past 10 years, it was nothing but a pipe dream and was totally out of my reach financially. In the meantime, I purchased a series of Vincent Repeat from the Black Lightning's then owner, and asked him to let me know if ever considered selling it. And did he? He assured me that he would, but it slipped his mind, and the guy who had the bike before me got in first. I phoned him about it, and he was very upset that he had forgotten our conversation. It would have cost me much less to have bought the bike from him 5 years ago, but then I wouldn't have the world record for the most valuable bike at auction. I try to see the positive wherever I can, and it is certainly the only world record that I'll ever get. I didn't attend the sale, as my wife had initially told me that I couldn't buy it. We are building a new house soon, and we had put money away for that project. On the morning of the auction, I tried my luck and asked once more if I could bid. She finally agreed on a figure that would be my limit. When the bike came up at the auction, my agreed limit came and went. The bike's new owner suggests that it will continue to be ridden on occasion. Credit William Mees. I was phone bidding, and I told Andy from Bonhams on the telephone that I had to stop or my wife wouldn't be happy. At home, my wife then put her hand up, which I took to mean put in one more bid, which I promptly did. This went on for a couple more bids until eventually the hammer came down, and I won the bike. How did it feel to win? At that point I was in shock. I couldn't believe that I'd bought it, nor work out why my wife had changed her mind. Her sister summed it up later. She said that she is very stubborn and doesn't like losing, so I guess that is how I ended up placing the winning bid. It would have been wonderful to have been there in person, but had I gone off on my own, I wouldn't have dared to keep bidding. There is probably a lesson in there somewhere, but I haven't quite worked it out yet. It is a bike that I had had my eye on for some time. Vincent, along with Bruff Superior, are the most coveted motorcycles in the world, and the Black Lightning is the pinnacle of the Vincent mark. It is one of only 9 matching numbers examples left in the world, and I believe the most original. To top it off, it held the Australian land speed record, so this is a seriously special machine. The Black Lightning is British built but made its name in Australia. Credit William Mees. I haven't quite worked that out. It will certainly get used though. I am a big believer that these great machines shouldn't get locked away never to be seen again. They were made to be used, and they should be. I will take it to rallies and fire it up and take it the runs. I don't think I will strip down to my bathing suit and take it to the salt flats of Bonneville, but you never know. It is not exactly a user-friendly bike, so I won't be taking it down to the corner shop to buy a loaf of bread, that's for sure. I was disappointed when it went out of the country. I feel that it belongs here and it was great to bring it back. I am very fortunate that I was in a position to do that.